What's up, Cougars? I'm Miller.
And I'm Ava, and welcome back to another episode.
On August 10th, the town held a celebration for the town mural being finished.
The mural of our 2022 Class 1A state champions includes Devin Collins, Marcus Britton, Jalen Mullen, Logan Wilson, Brendan Stickles, and Lance Wilson.
The mural was made by Travis Turner and North Daviess art teacher, Lindsay Seacrest.
Do you hear that?
It's time for the weather!
Welcome to your Cougar Weather,
where there's no such thing as bad weather, but only wrong clothes.
I'm Kobe.
And I'm Braylon.
And we're back to give you this week's forecast.
Today, there's partly cloudy skies with a high of 89 and a low of 60.
On Saturday, skies are continuing to be cloudy with the high being 90 and the low being 62.
Sunday, there is a high of 88 and a low of 61 with a UV index of 6.
Monday is going to have a 9-mile-an-hour southeast wind with a high of 85 and a low of 61.
On Tuesday, there will be a humidity of 60% with a high being 83 and a low being 60.
On Wednesday, there will be partly cloudy skies with a high of 81 and a low of 59.
Finally, Thursday, there will be a high of 82 and a low of 58. Possible showers could continue Thursday night with a 32% chance of rain.
And that's all for your Cougar Weather. Back off to Ava and Caleb.
Thanks, Kobe and Braylon. This year's winter semifinal has been moved to the fall.
It will be held on November 6th from 8 to 11 p.m.
Tickets will be sold during lunch A and C for $15 apiece from October 14th to October 25th.
Now to Michael and Bubba for specials.
Thanks, Ava and Caleb.
This is Bubba, I'm Michael, and this is Special Report.
This school year, North Daviess High School was granted the Fab Lab from the ORI.
The Fab Lab concept was originally developed at MIT and has since spread across the globe. There are now more than 1,500 Fab Labs worldwide.
The purpose of the Fab Lab was to give kids another angle of learning, teaching kids math, English, and music with an innovative approach.
This lab has provided educators with an insight into students' understanding, identifying areas of need, and monitoring academic progress throughout a course or lesson.
One of the hopes of the Fab Lab is to help kids work with their hands while still learning the information needed for the subject.
The Fab Lab is located in Mr. Collison's room. Any student is allowed and encouraged to use the Fab Lab with the permission of their teacher.
We interviewed Mr. Flint on the Fab Lab and see how everything works.
We're here with Mr. Flint today. So, Mr. Flint, tell us what this doohickey does.
This is a CNC router. We can put wood, plastic, some aluminum in there, and it'll carve out a design or maybe a piece of artwork or something. And we can do three-dimensional engravings. All kinds of little things.
Great.
So I heard you got some 3D printers up in here.
Yeah, come here, I'll show you. Nice. See, these are our Bamboo Lab X1 carbons. They each can do 4 different colors of filament, and they're self-contained. Like, you can use your smartphone to program them. They're pretty neat.
How long do they take?
Depends on how big the thing is you're printing. So like a little bitty earring or something like that might take 20 minutes. But we've actually had 3-day prints on them before where it takes a long time.
That's cool.
So, what else you got in here?
Well, come over here and I'll show you the laser. This is a CNC laser. We can engrave metal, Lexan, anything like that. Mr. Collison runs this area. He's doing a pretty good job. He's printing all kinds of neat things. We printed a laser cut a bunch of products for the antique show and sold a bunch of stuff. I think we sold $8,000 worth of products. Pretty cool.
Interesting. Very interesting. What else they got up in her?
Scroll saws. Miter saw.
Table saw.
Drill press.
Assorted power tools.
Sander.
What's this big dog?
Let me tell you. This is a plasma cutter, CNC. We can draw anything and cut it out of metal, just like that.
Just like this?
Yep. And this.
And this?
Yeah.
What else?
And we can cut these out.
They're pretty cool. Thank you, Mr. Flint.
Hey, no problem, bud, anytime. Come on back.
Yeah. We're the special reporters.
Back to Ava and Miller.
Thank you, Michael and Bubba. Last week on September 4th through the 7th, the White River Valley Antique Association held its annual antique show.
Many different events were held, including a tractor pull, a horse pull, a parade, and many little shops. It was a great turnout with thousands of people enjoying their time there.
Many student organizations and classes throughout the school were involved by helping Cougar Creations raise money to support student organizations and clubs in the school.
We checked in with several students who attended.
Okay. All right. What did you think about working at the antique show?
I thought it was fun.
All right, sweet. All right, who are we here with today?
Hannah.
What did you think about working at the antique show last week?
It was great. There was a lot of people working, so I kind of just stood around, but...
All right, thank you. Who are we here with today?
Will Murray.
What did you think about working at the antique show last week?
I think that Flint and Colson were preying on my downfall for no reason.
I love Trevor. What did you think about working at the antique show last week?
It was cool. It was fun, I guess.
Entertaining?
Yeah.
All right, thank you for your time, sir. Who are we here today?
Jaden.
What do you think about working at the antique show last week?
It was good. There was a lot of, like, opportunities to connect with people and talk to them and learn more about the business side of all that.
All right, thank you very much.
Now let's head over to sports with Aiden and Nate.
Thanks, Miller and Ava. Welcome back to Cougar Sports.
The varsity football team traveled to Princeton Friday where they played the Tigers. The Cougs beat the Tigers, winning 38-20. Our very own Keaton Graber had 3 rushing touchdowns and 1 passing touchdown.
JV football team traveled to North Knox to play the Warriors, where our very own Cole Boyd threw 1 touchdown with no interception, winning the game 22-6.
Tonight, the varsity Cougars traveled to Edinburgh to face the Lancers. Good luck tonight, boys. On Saturday, the Cougar volleyball team journeyed to North Vermilion, aiming to clinch their 3rd consecutive Falcon Invitational Championship. After a grueling 2-hour drive, the Cougars faced off against Duggar Union in their opening match. Despite a sluggish start, dropping the first set 25-22, the Cougars rallied in the second set. Junior Cambria Graber ignited the team with a series of powerful serves, putting the Cougars ahead 5-2 and later 8-2. Sophomore Alexis Tolbert sealed the second set with a decisive kill, leading the Cougars to a commanding 25-12 victory. Duggar Union had no response in the third set, which ended 15-6 in favor of the Cougars. In their second match of the day, the Cougars faced the host team, North Vermilion. The Cougars dominated the first set, starting with senior Laney Cornelius making the crucial block. A few points later, freshman Alan Smith contributed a key kill to the team, securing the set, 25-16. North Vermilion fought back in a second set, initially leading 12-7. Despite a strong ace from senior Kelsey Riggins, the Cougars dropped the set 25-17. The third and final set was the nail-biter, with both teams neck and neck at 12-12. Junior Cambria Graber broke the tie with a pivotal kill off the deflection, followed by an off-speed ace from senior libero Elena Smith, putting the Cougars up 14-12. North Vermilion managed to close the gap 14-13 with an aggressive kill from Falcons, but Graber once again delivered the decisive blow with a cross-court kill, securing the win and the championship for the Cougars. Senior Laney Cornelius led the Cougars offensively with 20 kills, while sophomore Alexis Tolbert was forced at the net with 4 blocks. Junior Cambria Graber contributed 5 aces with this victory. The Cougars have achieved a 3-peat at the Falcon Invitational. We caught up with senior setter Amaya McBride, who orchestrated the offense and defense with 45 assists and 21 digs, to hear her thoughts on this remarkable achievement.
I'm very excited that we won 3 years in a row and I got to win next to my best friends.
The Cougars JV volleyball team dominated their competition at the recent tournament, sweeping both Union Duggar and North Vermilion in straight sets. Against Union Duggar, they won by scores of 25-6 and 25-13. Their victory over North Vermilion was equally impressive, with scores of 25-15 and 26-24. The dominant performance earned the Cougars their championship trophy. Tuesday night, the Cougar volleyball team took on the Lakers at Shackamack. In a thrilling match, the girls came out strong, taking the first set with ease. However, the Lakers fought back fiercely in the second and third sets, putting on a lot of pressure. Despite a valiant effort on the fourth set, the Cougars ultimately fell to the Lakers 1-3. The junior varsity team also faced the Lakers on Tuesday night. Unfortunately, the Cougars couldn't secure a win, falling to the Lakers 0-2. Despite their best efforts, the junior varsity team couldn't overcome the Lakers' strong performance. The junior high Lady Cougars continue their winning streak. The 7th grade team improved their record to 10-1 with a victory over Shoals. Meanwhile, the 8th grade team fought hard but came up short against Shoals, falling to 5-6. Despite the loss, the 8th graders showed great determination and would be looking to bounce back in their next match. but the junior high Lady Cougars continue their winning ways. The 7th grade team improved their record to 11-1 with a victory over Clay City. Meanwhile, the 8th grade team secured a win, bringing their record to 6-6.
The Cougar tennis team cut down the hatches with a 5-0 win. Saul and Raver dominated the hatches at 2-3 singles. 1-2 dubs were next two off of the straight set victories over the hatchets. 1 singles was the only match that pushed after the first set. Schulte said, after the dominant first set, Lutter struggled to set with Meredith's serve and volley game. To Lutter's credit, he pushed on him in the third set and got him out of the tiebreak early. The Cougars continued their winning streak Saturday, defeating the Braves at Tecumseh by a score of 3-2. Stahl and Huff got the teams off with a strong start with two early wins. Graber and Raber suffered a loss, and Lohatter felt in a close match, tying the scores at 2-2. But it was a dynamic duo of Free and Callison who clinched the victory of the Cougars, winning their match in three sets. With this win, the Cougars improved their record to 11-2. Tuesday night was a special night for the Cougar varsity boys tennis team, as they hosted senior night against the Sullivan Golden Arrows. It was a thrilling match that went down to the wire. The Cougars emerged victorious with a 3-2 win. The victory improves their record to 12-2, showcasing the strong performance throughout the season. The junior high Cougars tennis team dominated their match against Vincent's Lincoln on Monday night, sweeping the Alices 5-0. The impressive victory showcased the talent and hard work of our young athletes.
Congrats to the girls' golf team for winning SWAC 3 years in a row, where the team scored a winning score of 372.
Ava Graber, Olivia DeHare, Mia Dalrymple, Emma Yoder, and Allison Knepp all received SWAC honors. Congratulations, girls.
Today, the girls' golf team is heading to sectionals. Good luck tonight, girls.
And that will be a wrap for Cougar Sports.
Now back to Miller and Ava.
Thank you, Aiden and Nate, for the sports updates.
This fall, the USDA Forest Service will be setting prescribed fires in the Hoosier National Forest.
Prescribed fires are used to maintain, restore, and improve early successional habitats. Also, they restore and maintain unique barren communities, restore oak hickory-dominated ecosystems, and reduce risk of fires by reducing the amount of woody material.
These fires will be conducted in Brown, Crawford, Jackson, Lawrence, Martin, Orange, and Perry counties.
During these procedures, smoke is an unavoidable consequence, and you should slow down and turn on your headlights if there is smoke covering the road.
If you plan on hunting or camping in an area close to the burn unit, contact the Indiana Interagency Coordination Center at 812-547-9262.
In honor of College Go Week, September 23rd through 27th, North Daviess will be participating in Spirit Days. Monday is Your Future is Bright, dress in neon, or your brightest collar clothing. Tuesday, be college ready and wear your favorite college apparel or school collars. We salute you on Wednesday, wear camouflage or red, white, and blue. Thursday's theme is hats off to a higher ed, wear your favorite college hat. Friday, your future starts now, wear your orange and black.
The Red Cross Club will host its fall blood drive on Thursday, October 24th in the Commons area. If you are 16 or older, you are eligible to donate. See Mrs. Stuffel to sign up for a donation slot.
Wednesday, September 25th is our second two-hour delay day. This year's fall break will be Monday, October 7th through Friday, October 11th, 2024. This year's fall senior night will be held on Friday, October 11th before the varsity football game against North Knox. Groups being recognized are football, cross-country, girls golf, boys tennis, cheerleaders, and marching band.
Archery will take place on Mondays and Thursdays in the auxiliary gym from 6 to 8 p.m. It is open to all junior high and high school students and will take place on Mondays and Thursdays through the end of October. There is no cost to participate.
On Saturday, September 28, 2024, Plainville will be the host to the Plainville Farm Market. The annual event is composed of small local businesses, food trucks, nonprofits, and other organizations. The fall market will be held at Plainville Park from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Admission and parking are free at this event.
Picture retakes will be on Friday, October 18th from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. in the Commons area. Show us your shelfie. The Media Center is hosting a selfie contest. Take a selfie with your favorite book. You can include your favorite people and pets, too. Email it to lshaw@ndavies.k12.in.us or stop by the library during passing period to airdrop it to Mrs. Shaw. The student and staff winners will be announced on the Cougar News. All entries must be submitted by October 1st, and photos must be school appropriate. yearbooks are on sale right now at jostens.yearbooks.com. The cost is $70 per book until Friday, October 11th.
Well, that's a wrap.
We'll see you next week.
And roll Cougs.